tell us how you play, buddy.
All right, excellent. So this is a prototype I've been working on. And so this game, we're going to, all the players are bear cubs. And we're cooperating together because we figured out that at the big bear party, that when all the bears get together just before they go to sleep for the winter, that if we can play the right number of games with each bear, they're going to go to sleep. And if we can get all the bears to go to sleep, then we cubs can play games all winter long. But if we can't put the bears to bed before that we run out of games, then we're going to be going to bed too. So that's our big challenge, right?
Excellent. So show me a little, let's take a little bit of how it plays.
All right. So basically, bears play games, and they're you know, sometimes they're quiet games. So if you play the game Barely a Whisper, that's only got about one level of noise. But you could play a big loud game like a big bear brawl, and that's going to make five noise. So each of the adult bears we know takes a number of loudness that they like to have before they go to sleep. So we have to play four games with each of these bears. But say Aunt Polar Bear here, we have to play four games with her, but all the games total have to be quieter than 10. Now Mother Bear, wow, she likes to play four games, but all together they've got to be louder than 18, right? So we've got to play the right number of games with each of these bears to put them to sleep, right? Now that sounds pretty straightforward, but a few challenges we have. You know, once a bear goes to sleep, a bear has a favorite game or two. So if we happen to be playing a game with a bear that's next to that one and we play its favorite game, well, it's going to wake right back up. So that's going to make a little bit of a challenge on what we've got to do. And then, of course, there's that annoying cousin, Jumping Junior. Now, she's on the big bear bed, and every time we play a game, say we play a game of three, she jumps one, two, three spaces. And every time she jumps on the edge of the bed, one of the bears that are already hibernating comes off of the bed and comes back in with our bears, right? So that's another problem that we've got to manage while we're putting these bears to sleep and barely asleep. So it's a cooperative game. We've each got three games that we can see, and so we can kind of chart out our path, and we know what's coming up. And as we draw games out of our little game shelf, there's always, you know, the next one there. So you'll have three games, and our other players here will each have three games. And I'll have three games. I won't put that right away. And so as we'll play one and we'll replace it from here. And as we draw off this deck, there's actually three of these Jumping Junior tiles in there. So even our most carefully planned way of keeping Jump Junior off the edge of the bed, sometimes she's just gonna have a giant jump and go right there to the edge of the bed. And playing the games is pretty straightforward. We can play a game with any bear. The next game that we play has to match either the number or the color of a game that's already been played with them. So if I played a green three here, or let's do a different sequence. Let's say a yellow two, I play this blue two. Now the next one could be any two, or it could be any yellow or any blue.
Okay. Yep.
And so that's simply how we do it. And so we've just got to try to put the bears to sleep, keep from waking up more bears, and watch out for pesky Jumping Junior.
Fair enough.